sign up is expecting his first child with his fiancée Danielle Purdy. She has announced in a sweet post in 2016, will become a father for the first time next year. In a sweet social media post uploaded by stunning brunette Danielle, Terry is seen beaming at the camera as the pair hold up a sonogram of their unborn daughter. Danielle wrote alongside the adorable image, "The best birthday present I could ever have wished for was seeing our baby again today. So special." Related articles. Get exclusive celebrity stories and fabulous photo shoots straight to your inbox with. You can sign up at the top of the page. We are absolutely over the moon to be expecting. We can't wait to meet our little darling. Due February 21st. Love you so much already. She soon returned to the social media platform to announce the gender of their first baby in a gorgeous video of them popping a huge balloon to see pink confetti fall. Danielle wrote, "It's a girl. Thank you to everyone that shared this special moment with us." Over the moon. The pair announced their engagement last month after the ongoing coronavirus pandemic put a stop to their romantic getaway to Paris. Showing off her sparkling engagement ring, Danielle once again wrote to her followers, "Last night I said yes to becoming Mrs. Walsh. Even though we were meant to be in Paris this weekend and this wasn't quite what he had planned, it couldn't have been more perfect." Sick. Related articles. I can't wait to spend the rest of my life with my best friend at Terry Walsh 88. I love you so much. Terry found fame on the second series of Love Island, causing a stir when he left Malin Anderson for new rival Emma Jane Woodham after the former's shock elimination. Both Malin and Emma have gone on to welcome their own children following their time on the show. Sadly, Malin's daughter Kanzi tragically passing away just 4 weeks after birth. Love Island stars. Related articles. Bravely opening up on the postnatal depression she suffered after Kanzi's passing, she told OK Online earlier this year, "I was so depressed and I would get really bad thoughts and imagery of her. I remember wondering what it was and it turned out to be intrusive thoughts. At the time, I made a vow that I would kill myself if she died. It took some amazing strength to bring myself back from those dark thoughts. They carry on for a while too, because you're in denial of things that are happening to you. I had to save myself from it. I educated myself on it. I had therapy instantly and I realized that it was okay to feel upset.